Greetings, people. Paul Mokko here again. Now, people, I have a kind of interesting video to make, right? And a friend of mine shared a video with me. It's called Healing Leaf, film about raw cannabis juice. The point being, right, people, it's a very good video. I think all of you should watch it. However, where I got turned off in this video is where the sheriff came in and started talking his mess, okay? And I'm gonna make the point after let y'all hear a few minutes of the video, okay? It's very important. Hear this few minutes first, and I'm gonna give y'all my opinion, okay? All right, here goes.
It's hard for me to understand laws against something like green leaf therapy and to think that prednisone is legal.
We're still fighting the stigma of marijuana back from the 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s. I was a prosecutor for 8 years in Mendocino County, so I know it from both as a defense attorney and as a prosecutor. The 1972 Controlled Substances Act said that marijuana has no medical value whatsoever.
The federal government has a patent on its medical products. The Food and Drug Administration has approved it as an investigative drug.
I have not found the United States to be very open about cannabis research. In order to print an article in a peer-reviewed journal, have to use cannabis that they've certified for your study. And there are physicians who've waited 3, 4, 5, 6 years, some even longer than that, to just get a sample.
The federal government's been kind of schizophrenic in the way it looks at marijuana. It says it has no medical value under that act, but at the same time, the federal government has been funding research in marijuana for years or decades. And they've even patented certain strains of marijuana because they recognize it has its that medical value. The California Narcotic Officers Association does not believe in medical marijuana. They believe it's all a big scam, and that's how they train law enforcement officers. Law enforcement is allowed to take a percentage of all assets that are forfeited and seized under the state and federal asset forfeiture law. So it takes the really enlightened and compassionate law enforcement officer to recognize that these medical marijuana laws are designed to protect patients.
I was trained when someone had marijuana, you took them to jail. There wasn't a medicine used for marijuana. It's an illegal substance, and people went to jail for it. In 1996, California took a huge leap. I didn't support Proposition 215 because of the education I had, the experience I had, and what I had seen through the illegal marijuana gardens that I had seen throughout my career. Since 1996, I have changed my opinion somewhat. I believe there is a very clear medicinal use for marijuana. That being said, I believe that there are a large percentage of people who use marijuana as an excuse to either make profits or for recreation. The people who use marijuana for the true intended use that the voters passed, medicinal, I'll do everything I can to support their rights. There's many more things that law enforcement can be focused on than medicinal marijuana. And I don't want to give the impression at all that I support people who are growing marijuana for medical purposes 364 days a year, and then one day a year they make a big sale for a couple $100,000, and they're a commercial seller that one day of the year. They're the people who are causing problems for the people who really and truly need and can use medical marijuana.
So people, do y'all hear that, what that sheriff just said? People, don't y'all see the hypocrisy? The government knows that marijuana can cure people, can keep them from dying. But to prevent the poor man from making a living, the government would rather let people die than let a ganja farmer make a decent living. What the hell? People, do y'all see the hypocrisy? The government cares not that you smoke marijuana, use it for medical purposes. The government cares that people are able to make money off of it. The government was against alcohol until they were able to regulate and control it. The government don't care if you destroy yourself. But then they realize, wait a minute, we could also control the economy with it also. Secondly, people, that sheriff talk about how he respect the use of marijuana for medical purposes. People, don't you ask the idiocy and hypocrisy of this whole thing? People, isn't prevention better than cure? So people, if marijuana could cure my illness. What better thing to stop me from getting ill than to use marijuana? Don't the doctor say to tell old people, senior people to take aspirin? They say take my aspirin because it's gonna decrease your risk of getting a heart attack. They tell you that. Take aspirin because it decreases your chance of getting a heart attack. So tell people, smoke your marijuana, drink your juice, use marijuana, so it will prevent you from getting sick. You all are so silly and backwards. Okay, don't you all see government, don't you all see that you all are the people not falling for your tricks no more? Okay? And another thing, people, I'm gonna get to this, right? Okay, you all know I made my own video, right? Irrefutable proof, you know, of the pineal gland and connection to marijuana. Right, people? I made my video and I get a lot of love, but I get a lot of haters too. This guy is saying, right? Hear him. This guy that make this video and woman talking and included video are both way out. She can't even read, speak properly. Pineal gland. Dumb, dumb, dumb. Hey, he said, right, smoking marijuana from carbon that black radar, perhaps you should eat a bunch of charcoal instead. If you are not familiar with DMT, you don't know anything about the pineal gland. Because people made a claim, right, that smoking marijuana, right, blocks subliminal message to our pineal gland. I made a claim, right? And hold on, let me show you all the claim I made. Okay. See the claim I made? I said this works for me. Carbon is good to block radar. Ganja produces a pure form of carbon. Ganja smoke is good to block interference to a pineal gland. Now people, do you know where I get this concept from? Back in World War II, right? The Allies discovered, right, that if they coated their airplanes with carbon, it would hard for the Germans to detect them, right? They used to wrap cardboard in tin foil and drop it over Germany. And the German anti-aircraft guns, of course, used to follow the tin foil because it's a metal. You could follow it with your radar. So the Allies would wrap tin foil inside carbon coated paper, and when they drop the carbon coated tin foil, the German radar couldn't pick it up. Our brains are like freaking instruments, fools. Our brains work with electromagnetical signals. So therefore, if radar can detect machineries, why couldn't it interfere with our brains also? So, therefore, carbon coats some part of our brains and it blocks interference from radar. So, and I can understand this guy's concept. I can understand people's concept that carbon could destroy your brains. Of course it can. Of course it can destroy your brains. And for this guy to say, I don't know anything about the pineal gland, I'm going to prove to him that it is him who don't know anything about the pineal gland. I'll prove it to you right now, you don't know anything about the pineal gland. Okay? I'm gonna prove it to you. Okay, you see that picture right there? The first time I see a picture with those two dark lines coming down my face. Can y'all see? And the flame in my eye. The first time I see that picture, people, I was terrified. I almost threw it away. Matter of fact, it's not even a picture, it's a video, people. It's a video. I was on my roof playing around with the sun, saying, let me see what will happen if I put this camera in my face. That's all I did. And when I came down, I was horrified when I said, I didn't understand it. I was like, what the hell is that? Because it was more than that. It was a video. And at this time, people, I didn't know what it was. I said, why am I crying? What are those black things? I didn't know what it was, people. And all this time, people, right here with this chart right next to me all this time, this chart was right here. And I didn't even realize that's what it was. I didn't know what it was. I I almost delete the video. Matter of fact, people, I can't even find the video anymore. I took this picture out of the video with the intent of deleting them. I only did it to see what they were, people. The only reason why I have these pictures, right, is because I wanted to see what it was. And I deleted the video because, like, what the hell is that? And I didn't delete this because I couldn't find the file. It was only one day after I seen this stuff, I was like, what the hell? Actually, before I know where that was, right, I had an inkling because I knew about his Eyes Like a Flame of Fire. So I was using it with a concept of his Eyes Like a Flame of Fire. And when I made this video, I swear to you all, people, this video is a remix. When I first made the video about marijuana and smoking, I didn't know anything about no pineal gland. If you look at the first video, you will see nothing about no pineal gland. But you see this video, with everything I said, but it doesn't have the word pineal gland. And this lady is not on here. This is just a remake. So I didn't know what it was. It was after I seen this video. You know the introduction? That lady, right, after I seen that part of the video, was when I realized that, wait a minute, that's the pineal gland. So then, the point I'm trying to make, right, people, is that this guy gonna criticize me saying I don't know about the pineal gland. I'm gonna prove to you all now that if you and real who criticize me don't know don't know anything about the pineal gland. You don't know nothing about the pineal gland, I'll prove it to you. What does the pineal gland signify, people? Look at it. What does it signify? Okay, the left eye of Harold lost in his fight with Seth. Restored by Tiuri, the which the widget was worn as a pendant to ward off evil and give the wearer protection. What does it symbolize? Healing, protection, and health. That's what it symbolizes. So the point being, people, right? If the pineal gland symbolizes healing, protection, and health, and you smoke marijuana that put carbon in your lungs and carbon in your brains, and your pineal gland is truly activated, won't your pineal gland be able to give you healing, protection, and health? It's a divine thing, isn't it? It's powerful. Isn't the pineal gland supposed to help to heal yourself? Isn't it, people? Healing, protection, and health. So therefore, Mr. People who want to call me dumbass, and all of you, if I make a claim saying that, if I make this claim saying carbon is good to block radar and ganja produces a pure form of carbon, ganja smoke is good to block interference with pineal gland, what's wrong about that if the pineal gland can give me healing, protection, and health from what? From the carbon. Because obviously the pineal gland can be interfered with by radar, by subliminal messages, because that's why it's a perception. It's like whiskers on a cat. If you touch it, it's gonna stimulate. So therefore, radar can stimulate it. It's not gonna block it, because it was meant to react to stimulation. It was meant for that. It has no defense mechanism against interference. So it is you who gotta put the to block from interference. Just like you could, there's a fluoride mess with it. If you take fluoride, you cannot stop it because you have no defense mechanism. So therefore, it is you who must give it its defense mechanism. And I gave it with marijuana, with carbon, because marijuana, not only does it stimulate the pineal gland, it coats it with carbon so that it cannot be interfered with. And then, by its power, it can remove the carbon so that it doesn't block up the pineal gland, so you don't get cancer, so you won't get any diseases. So the point I was trying to make about marijuana healing people, right? Using marijuana as a drink or as a smoke is not going to do any damn harm to you, because guess what? It stimulates your pineal gland and it gives you healing, protection, and health. Okay, so now you all know why marijuana is good for you, people. It opens your pineal gland and it gives you healing, protection, and health. So all you people out there who want to say marijuana is bad for you, it gives you healing, protection, and health. Okay, how much more simple can I put it? So all you who want to disrespect me and tell me I don't know what the hell I'm talking about, it is you who know what you talk about. Because if your penis will truly open up, as you claim it was, it will give you healing, protection, and health. So therefore, your pineal gland is not open. You are lying. You are a liar. There's no balance in your life. There's no harmony. Because there was, you may come in here and try to disrespect me to a claim which you cannot prove. Okay, that's it. I'm done.